Hi guys, welcome to Naresh IT. This is Sudhakar and today we are going to discuss about character data types in SQL Server. Okay, so character data types is very important, okay, and most oftenly we are going to using in our development of applications. It's nothing but designing of tables, whatever it is there. So there we can use the mostly these kind of data types, okay. And character data types, okay, I said more often we are using one, and what kind of information it will be stored, and how many types of the character data types was classified, and each type, which kind of data types which comes under, okay. These all one by one we can go to check, okay. So now listen here, the first I will go to character data types, okay. So now here character data types are used for storing the string format values, remember, because so many people they thought like that the character data types are going to store characters, they are thinking like that, but here don't say character data types are going to store characters, okay. If you say like this, this is wrong way definition, okay. Why? Because simple thing I'm asking, the simple thing I will tell you one small example. Name is a column, so name is a column name. On this column, if I applied here char of some size I was given, one of the data type I was taken from character data types, okay. So this is assume like this one of your column. In this column, if I want to insert, okay, some expressions I am going to insert it here. But remember, character data types are used to store characters, means if I send one character expression, for example Sai, if I send Sai, as per your definition, these are characters. But once I inserted these characters into this column, this is not accepted. Okay, it is not accepted. But you said character data types are used for storing characters now. But why this one is not accepted? Because I am sending characters only. I am not sending any other format. I am sending which format? Character format only I am sending. But even though it is not accepted into your column, because of the reason is what now? Are you sending characters? Okay. But what I said, character data types are used for storing string format values. Okay. So this is not accepted. But the same expression, if I given along with my single quote, if I given along with single quote, then it was accepted into your tape column. Okay, now in this two you can observe the same name Sai Sai, but here I am sending Sai without a string representation, and here I am sending Sai with the string representation. So without string representation, if user try to insert the value into the column, character column, it is not accepted, I said. But the same characters once you send along with string representation, then it is called a accepted. Your expression is going to inserting into your column. So by this example, what do you understand here? Character data types are accepted string formats value only. The point was clear. Okay. So now we can see now. So this is the difference. By seeing this example, now I'm going to defining my character data type. Okay. So what I'm saying here. Okay. So now as per this example, what I am saying here, character data types are used for storing which format values? I said here string format or string values only. String values only accepted. But in database, every string expression should be represented with a single quote. For every string expression, you should be represented with a single quote. That point should be remembered. Okay. So now, but this string values, the string values I said, the string values may be, here the two things are there. What it is nothing but, the first one we called as a only character strings, only characters strings expressions. Otherwise, alphanumeric characters. So now the string representation or string expression may be characters, otherwise alphanumeric characters. Then what is the differences between characters and alphanumeric characters are nothing but, characters means in this expression I will be take only alphabets only, that means A to Z, capital A to Z you can take, or else small a to Z you should take. Okay, so that means either you can input your characters along with your string expression, either uppercase characters, otherwise lowercase characters, the both are you can send it. For example, what is my example now? My example is Naresh, I am sending now. Naresh IT, I was sent. In this Naresh IT expression, we have only characters, but this expression should send along with the string. And carefully observe here, in this character only I was taken, only characters I was taken. These characters I send along with my string representation of single quotes. Once I will send, this is also accepted. But in this expression, I am using only characters. Remember, this is what we called a characters data or characters only. Next one, when come to alphanumeric characters. Alphanumeric characters is nothing but simply what I am saying here. It will be accepted capital A to Z or else small a to Z. When come to alphanumeric characters, in this we can use either A to Z, capital A to Z, otherwise a small a to Z, you can use it. Along with these characters or alpha bits, I can use number also. The number may be 0 to 9. So 0 to 9 number also can include. Along with number, we need to use special characters. Special characters also you can use it. So now, when the combination of characters, numbers, special characters, this kind of combination of expression, once you can send or once you can insert, this kind of data is called as a alphanumeric data. For the best examples of alphanumeric data, generally very oftenly we are going to interacting for like our mail IDs, user mail ID. Otherwise, you can see your PAN code number. The PAN code number also alphanumeric data. Why? Because in PAN code number, we are going to combine characters and number. So user ID, PAN code numbers, sometime you can see the student all ticket numbers also you can take alphanumeric nowadays. So these are comes under what now? Alphanumeric data. For example, to understand now, I am going to using here one example, I will show it. What is my example now? I am going to take here single quote, open single quote, it's a mandatory. Later same to same, Naresh IT 123 at the rate, for example, gmail.com I was given. So Naresh IT 123 at the rate gmail.com, this is one ID I was given. But in this ID, can you see carefully, we have a characters, these are characters. And this is number, this one is special character. So that means in this string expression, I am going to sending here characters, numbers and special characters I am sending. When you send like this, the combination, this is called as a alphanumeric data. So that means finally what you understand here, character data types are storing string values. Okay. But the string value, it may be characters only. Otherwise, the string value, it may be alphanumeric characters also. So, characters, alphanumeric data, the both characters data, alphanumeric data, the both kind of information I can insert, I can store under character data type column. But whatever you send, characters, otherwise alphanumeric, these two expressions you must and should be sent along with the single quote representation. This is mandatory. Now we can see the example. Here I was given Naresh IT, but I used single quotes here. And here I used nareshit123@gmail.com, but even though I used my single quote. So the single quote should be represent. If you represented single quote, then both kind of information I can store in my character data type column in the table. This is what it is here, character definition. The character data is for what purpose I can use, what kind of values are storing, and what are those we discuss. But these character data types, again it was classified into the two categories. The what kind of categories was classified here, now I will go to list out the complete categories. I will list out and later one by one we will discuss. Okay, now let us see. Okay, so now I am going to list out the complete categories of character data types. Okay, how many types it was classified, now we can check. Character data types again classified into two categories. First category we called as a non-Unicode data types. Second one we called as Unicode data types. Okay, so these are the two categories are there. So let us find out here in these two categories what kind of data types are comes under. Now when come to non-Unicode data types, again these data types are, okay, some types it will be divide here. Okay, first one we called as a char of size is the first data type. Later I will go varchar of size is another one. Otherwise same varchar data type if I am using along with the max keyword, that called varchar of max. And later if you go to, okay, the last one is text. So here these are called a non-Unicode data types. But in place of these two, okay, we can also write simply, I can write like this in place of these two, varchar of size or max. Even though I can say, no problem. Because size is separately defined, max is separately defined here. But at a time you can write like this also. So these data types are comes under non-Unicode category. In the same to same when come to Unicode data types. So these data types, how it will work and what kind of data types are comes under in this category means, now you can check. In this category, again same to same, we have some categories. First one, nchar of size. Second one, nvarchar of size. Otherwise, nvarchar of max. And finally, nText. So these data types which was comes under Unicode category. But again these two, again I can write simply nvarchar of size or max. Okay, again you can say like this. So these are completely the two types of categories of character data types, and these are the data types which was comes under in each category. But the thing is what it is here, okay, I was show you the data types here, but you have a question. What is your question here? Unicode data types and non-Unicode data types, what is the difference? The differences in between Unicode, non-Unicode is the first question you will be raised. Later, Unicode data types and non-Unicode data types, where I can use, at the situation where I can use it. The real-time people are, where the people are using these data types, when they are going to design their tables or any database application, whatever. So now I will give some differences in these two. What is that means? Non-Unicode data types, whatever it is there, these data types basically we are going to using, basically we are going to using, or the people in real time where the people are using means, whenever the user is going to store localization or localized data. When I want to store my localized data, then I can use these data types. Simple point, remember. When I was store localized data, then I can use these data types. That is called a non-Unicode data types. Exactly where I can use. Same to same, when come to your Unicode data types where I can use means, same. Unicode data types I can use when I want to store globalized data. So, whenever I want to store globalized data, then I can say, or I can use Unicode data types. Because simple I can say, what is that? Unicode is nothing but universal supported data. Non-Unicode is nothing but what now? Non-universal supported data. So, that means, this data types are char, varchar of size or varchar of max text is going to use it to store your localized data only. It's supported. But localized data, globalization of data, it means what it is actually. It means simple for your understanding I will give. Localized data is nothing but it will supports English culture only. So, it supports English culture. That means English culture information or data you can directly store in this data type columns. English means, you know, it is a local language of the universal. Simply, you know, the universal local language, anybody ask, then simply what we are saying? English. English is a local language of the universe. As per this point, what I am taking here, localization data. This is common for entire universal. Later on, Unicode I said. In Unicode data types, what it is here? Globalization. Globalization is nothing but supports all cultures. So, all cultures means, in universal, not only English now, there are so many different kind of cultures are there. In universal, different countries are there. For each country, they have their own culture. As per this scenario, what we said, Unicode data types are used for to store globalization data or global data is nothing but all culture. But here all culture is nothing but all cultures, I said. All cultures is nothing but, okay, here observe the what it mean. Here every data type was having here N, I was given. Here N is represented what it is now, national languages. So, that means all cultures are nothing but all national languages, all national languages. So, in the universal, how many national languages are there that all national language culture I can store? This is what we called a universal supported data types. This is the differences between Unicode and non-Unicode, localization data, globalization of data, okay. And here N is nothing but national languages, remember, okay. So, here all national languages are supported, okay. So, now this is what it is here, the differences between Unicode and non-Unicode data types. But in this point, you have a question. What is your question here? This is what non-Unicode data types I said and supported only English culture. There I said globalization of data supported all cultures. So, that means English culture also I can store in my Unicode data types. Yes or no? Yes. Because that is a global. Global means including English also. It is called a globalization. When English also supported to store in this category data types, then what is the use of this? You have a doubt. For this purpose, what you want to do, the one more difference you can see. Non-Unicode data types, whatever it was there here, these data types will allocating 1 byte memory per one character. So, that means if these data types, if I take, The memory allocation was like this, 1 byte is equals to 1 character. This is the way of mechanism in your non-Unicode data types. But the same to same Unicode, when you come to Unicode, it will allocate 2 bytes of memory is equals to 1 character. So, as per this point, can you see this? Here memory is saved, here memory is wasted. For example, if I stored Sai expression, for example, if I stored Sai expression in my non-Unicode data type column, either char, var char, whatever, here occupied 3 bytes of memory. But the same information, same Sai, if I stored in my Unicode data type, it will take 3 into 2, 6 bytes of memory. So, as per this scenario, what it is here, the memory is saved here, that is memory wasted. This is another difference in between non-Unicode and Unicode. Okay. So, these two points should be remembered. Localization data is nothing but English culture. Allocating the memory for each byte is equals to 1 character. Their globalization of data, all cultures, all national languages, and allocating 2 bytes for 1 character. This is the difference of Unicode and non-Unicode data types. Okay. So, now I hope that you can understand the what exactly the difference and categories. Okay. And later in the next session, we will check the differences between character and var char data types. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.